Which are the main ideas of this initiative? Why is it necessary in this moment?
Yes, the news in that entrepreneurship education is becoming real. A political priority for European Parliament and for European Commission too. So not only on the paper, but also in the concrete activities, we have got enough evidence that entrepreneurship education skills and competition and competencies can be taught and can be learned. So we have experiences that it works, that entrepreneurship skills has impact on employment and on social inclusion. Our report calls Commission and Member States to support and implement entrepreneurship education fellow these ways, promoting defined content and tools for formal and non-formal education in theoretical and practical modules. It's the first. The second and phases, practical training and experiences of both students and teachers. Supporting enlarging qualification of teachers in entrepreneurship education. And we call the Commission to strengthen the funding within the Erasmus Plus program and coordinate the sharing of best practices. It is important for promoting these activities.
What do you think about the results of these programs targeting the youth unemployment so far? The European policies, do you think there are things that may be changed or the results are satisfactory?
Yes, I think that many member states understand these activities and now it is necessary it enlarging. Yes, it enlarge. So what is necessary is also that European Commission support it in funding, and I think we can achieve that it improve and it help to young people for employment or for entrepreneurship. We have this experience and we hope that it we hope that it will work.
Do you think that will appear other initiatives in this sector dedicated to employment, mm-hmm. dedicated to entrepreneurship, to activities, maybe volunteering activities or anything that may mm-hmm. be useful for the professional career?
Yes. Yes, there are activities as youth junior achievement. It is very interesting activities of NGO, and I have many experiences from, for example, Czech Republic, that in schools they practice this program of junior achievement. So now it is necessary it realize it, and it promote for all young people. So it is our
to extend
to enlarge in all type, in all level of schools.
Okay. What about the young people from Europe that wish to have a career in the European institutions?
I am.
Do you have a message for them? Maybe some advice?
Yes. I think that young people have a good opportunity to come to European Parliament for visits and for training, as trainees, trainee. For example, I have myself experience that I invited about five young people to training, and they have a good start for next career. Here you can see that many young people who visit this parliament.
Yes, and this possible also in other European institutions?
Yes, I think that also in European Commission and Council it is possible, but for me as the members of Parliament, it is more easy to invite to European Parliament.
Yes, of course.
And I have also the trainer in Czech Republic for they work for my office in institutions in Czech Republic, for example in committee for Czech Parliament, and they participate in other events in Czech Republic, and so we have contact, we start your career.
Is it hard to become an employee in an MEP office? In maybe to or in other incident.
Yes, it is because
jobs.
it is many interests. So I have two choice. So
competition,
of course, yes, competition. But I have some experience with some people from schools, from universities. Mm-hmm. So it's the often there are the students who I know. So mm-hmm. because I am I have many contact with universities. So I invite the teachers or students, and I have communication with them. So then I can choose some students who I know a little bit.